Hey guys, so I'm going to be recording another episode of this because I'm like hooked on this game. It's weird for me. I'm not like I'll get hooked on games a lot of times. I might record something else after this as well, but I also need to render out a video for today. So I'm sorry that this is going to be a series that's going to be like playing a lot on my channel, but like, honestly, this game is just amazing. I can't exactly remember where I found out about them having this. I can't remember if I got it from, like, Jotun actually saying something about their game coming out soon or whatever. Okay. Anyways, that's not the door I want to go through. I want to go through this door and get some coins first, and then... I think I'm going to work my way to the boss again. I think I can beat that boss. I just need to calm down and think. I mean, it's very simple to evade his attacks. I just wasn't thinking correctly. I want to say it's a female character. Again, I'm still caught up on trying to figure out. I'm fairly certain it's a female character, though. The body looks more slender. The way that the person attacks like this, it looks like you can see her face slightly. And then I can't tell if it's supposed to be, like, bulkiness or, like, you know, like, boobage, that there's, like, a little bump there in that area. But the stance looks very, like, feminine, I guess you could say. I don't even know how that pose works. I couldn't even stand in that pose without being like, ah, pain! So much pain! You may think I'm joking, and I'm slightly joking, but it's also true, and like, that would hurt a lot. See, I still think if I had gotten through that door, I think I can still open that door and get to the boss fight a lot easier than having to go through all these guys. And I don't know what you get out of boss fights. Fuck you. Oh god, that was dangerous. Come on, have one of these give me, like, one of those health elixirs. I could really use it. I wanted to do that. That was just one of those things that's like, that would be fun to do. Some of these things feel very close cut for evasion. Okay, I only have two gunshots left. And if I can destroy this thing, Yes, I am literally just trying to destroy that thing for coins. Oh god, are you kidding me? Where are they? Fuck it, I'm going. I like how they just throw themselves off the edge. Like, what a world, what a world! I know I can. Fuck it, this episode right here is determined to beat that boss. There may be some cuts. We'll see how long I end up taking to actually beat that boss. Just cuts back, I have all the trees filled out. It's like, okay. Maybe now I can beat that one mini boss. That would be my luck, though. Okay, so there we have reduced damage taken. I'm also so tempted to just go to the right down here. Because I haven't done that yet. But I've already determined this boss right here, I'm pointing at myself, is determined to beat that boss. Why? Because why the hell not? It will know my pain as it suffers. I could, like, shoot that. I don't know what that blue thing's supposed to be. Did I just kind of hover through a wall? Meh, whatever. Those things happen. Fuck you, cultist. Nope. Yes. Well, this is a lot of coin. I can't just pass this up. Oh, I didn't even make the jump. Over there. Seems whenever a cultist is nearby, they'll lock up an area for to fight me in. Aha, I broke it. Oh, not good. Well, I didn't kill that cultist. These cultists are annoying as he locks down this small area. That one coin's just like, hey, wait for me! I'm here! Okay. I don't want to just rush over to the to that one area. Oh god, I think I saw a cultist. No, I saw that beam being shot out, okay. I did see a cultist. They're not incredibly tough to beat, at least. They are very annoying to fight around. The fact that I deal so much more damage is just like... so useful. That almost seems like a shield thing or some sort of... maybe it's for energy? But energy regenerates by itself, so I'm not certain why they would have something like that. Nope. That's not the way I want to go. I can't go anyway that way, so... interesting room design right there. Like, it definitely does seem like the cultists teleport away. Okay. If I can get a really nice hit on him early on. Or I can play the waiting game. Oh, he doesn't seem to attack me unless he can see me. Oh no, it's proximity based. Okay. God damn it. Come on, get your ass down here. Fuck you! 4,000 coins. And... Elder Shard. Visit an available an ability to shrine to reveal its true power. Oh man. I beat him! And got a shitload of coins out of it too. So the entire thing about this is you can choose to embrace the darkness to become more powerful. And I'm trying to decide if that's what I want to do. Let's be honest. I'm probably going to play through this game when it officially is, like, released as well. Of course. Hey, what do you know? It took me less time than I thought it would. Or than I even thought it might. Okay, so it wants you to go there after you beat that. But I beat that boss. But now I have no way up. I think the entire point is you're supposed to, like, fight your way up through these things, and then eventually you can get your way all the way back to the beginning, almost. Alcove of Grief. Come on, I need more healing things, honestly. Wait, what is that one? Oh. Nope. I'm out. I ain't facing a devourer. Not dead. Now he's dead. 5,000 coins. Okay. Oh my god, my heart's racing. And there we go. Oh man. I've opened up all the doors down here. I've got no health. Okay, they're all dead. Okay, so that's locked as a back way. Which means you have to come back. You come back through that direction instead of, like, Oh my god. A Lith Devourer? Is that supposed to be talking about Lilith? No. Different. That's a different mythology or mythos or however you want to put it. Oh my god, so much. Critical hit chance, or do I got a shitload of points right now. Boom. Holy shit. I now have that. Your attacks destroy enemy projectiles. Oh my god. I skipped out on critical hit chance for it, but you know what? Fuck it. I cannot afford anything else. Okay. What did I even get out of that? Because I didn't even actually look at what I got out of it. Okay, so I got luck, health, damage, cannon damage, and that. Oh wait, I got more damage. I want to see how much damage am I at now? 151. I gained 16 damage there. I need a new perk. But if you look, right, there's a connection between those two. Which is rather weird, don't you think? Okay. I kind of want to know if there's actually a boss in there to beat. I can't even use these. Where do I use these shards though? I need an altar. Which, by the way, it looks like you came out of another door that in and of itself is locked as well. Okay, so I'm gonna go. I think I'm gonna see where this place leads to. If I go down and to the right. I mean, I unlocked that entire middle section so I can go any of these directions, which is like actually kind of what I wanted to do with that run. That was actually a very nice run for that. Oh crap, I wasted a. Oh yeah, I forgot you can waste these things in here. Because that makes perfect sense. I'm full of health. I could use some healing. Okay, so down into the right instead of down into the left. There's got to be some way of actually being able to, like, move through those, like, things unhindered. Oh my god, look at that damage. I'm, like, reaching the 200... I hit a 236 damage hit. I wonder if there's a point in this game where you can one-shot things, these, like, weak guys. God damn it. Let me through. Are you kidding me? Oh yeah, that's right. Boom! Swing. Your shot not connecting with me anymore. Now I just get shot and I just have to swing. I'm a Jedi now. Or, like, other things like that. I'm actually unable to think of other things because the swooshing for this sounds so much like a lightsaber blade. Or at least in my head, what I think a lightsaber blade would sound like. Which, I mean, back then, the noise for, like, movies and stuff like that was very simplistic, so it was just like you taking a tube and swinging it fast, and that's how you would get noises for stuff. A balloon used to be like an animator's favorite toy for making music, for making noise for anything. You can do so many things with a balloon. Oh, fuck. Okay, so that's an impossible way to go. Thanks for telling me. So I wasted my health and my time for nothing. Because there's no way I can make it out of that if I tried to go that way. Like, look, I three-shot those guys. They have something like 300 health, it looks like. I was always the guy in most games who was like, yep, best way to survive, do more damage than the other guy. Kill him before he gets a chance to hit you. It's a pretty solid way of doing things in most games. So now there should be a bridge here that leads up, yep. Okay, since that way is a bust because there's no way through there, I'm gonna go down and see if I can find that boss. Hey, if I can beat that boss, that'd be actually kind of interesting. I got a load of coins that I can get from here, so why not? Okay. Okay. I'm like focusing so hard right now on this. Was that really the entirety of the fight? Visit Ability Shrine to reveal its true power. Is Ability Shrine even in the game yet? Or do I have, or is it those like areas I've already been to that I got abilities from? Are those the ability shrines? I'm not gonna lie, I was actually expecting that boss fight to be hard. I was expecting to get in there and probably die. I was not expecting to get down there, find out it's just a priest, which is essentially like an easy cultist, and just swing them to death. I think that has a purpose, but like, I'm gonna be honest, that was a little underwhelming for me. Okay, so you... Oh man, the background went trippy. And I should not have been the only one to see that. Fairly certain someone... Oh my god, it is trippy. What the hell? What is this all about? Oh my god. Oh god. I know why it's trippy now. This is bad. Becoming corrupt. Embrace the shadows. So now the entire attack has changed. That looks fucking awesome. Okay, so that's why I went trippy there. I'm a little worried because I know that's a bad thing. I know I did a bad thing there. I know that's a really bad thing. I'm saying that a lot, but that is a bad thing for me to have done. But, like, I don't know if there's something else you can do with those other than actually use them. Like, for all I know, that would be actually, you know what would be really awesome? A way of destroying those crystals. Maybe it doesn't give you anything useful, just like, but it would be awesome as an idea to just be able to, like, go, I don't want to, and destroy the crystals. Or you can make it where you can trade them into something else to get, like, you know. Because that, honestly, that trippiness actually was like, I kind of wanted to trade it just to get rid of that trippiness. I know that's kind of a horrible thing to do, like, in a way, corrupting your character's soul just to get rid of the trippy effect I'm getting from the game. Fucking hell. I wonder how that affects the actual tree that I'm building from it. Or if it even does. Because me as a player, I would want it to actually affect like my like skill tree, just because I think it would be a neat idea. I really wanted to get that other skill tree. I was so close too. If that thing hadn't locked me in there, I would have just ran past everything and kept going. I would have just booked it straight there to get it. But anyways, we got a lot of coins for upgrades again. Maybe this time I'll take the critical hit upgrade. Let's see what that did. Does that do anything to the tree? No, it doesn't. I want to know what that other. See, I want to know what the other skills are so badly because it's just like, to me, it's like, okay, what are they? What is it? Tell me your secrets. I mean, I do this and that's 200% with a 15% chance of getting it. Then I can go up here and get this, and I'm not going to be able to get all this. So let's start off with what I know I can get. What do I want? Well, I don't have critical hit chance, so I'm gonna go for either one of those. This would spend a lot of my points just to get higher health regen. Or I can just not go that way and take the luck damage and then more health from the elixirs. Which honestly would be very useful. Higher shards, higher damage. That, oh god, there goes, that took all my points. 1300 to get that? I mean, this tree is almost completely filled up, by the way. I think I've gotten every damage on that tree. I have. I've gotten every damage on this tree. 167. God, I feel bad about this. Like, let's be honest though. It looks fucking awesome. It grants greater range and probably more damage to the ability, but that's a cost of my soul. But I did say I was thinking about doing this one as like a run where I would go corrupt to just try and get this stuff. I am so glad I never equipped this thing. Enemies dropping 50% fewer shards would be horrible right now. Just because of the fact that it's like, well, sure, I get a second life. Actually, you know what? If I want to go for that power, I might as well equip that, because I can unequip them. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you guys are enjoying this as much as I am, and I hope you all have an amazing day.